NBC 26 News update. I'm Nina Sperano. It's a little too early to think about snow, but supply chain issues are impacting snow blowers. According to reports, Ahrens is manufacturing snow blowers at its plant in Brilliant, but because it doesn't have enough parts, the company has been trucking the unfinished equipment to a warehouse in Kenosha. About $12 million worth of inventory is just sitting in there awaiting engines and other components. Republican candidate for Governor Rebecca Clayfish has tested positive for COVID-19. Her campaign says she was exposed to the virus September 12th and received a positive test result Friday. Clayfish says she is feeling fine and she is fully vaccinated. In other news, a sixth-generation farm in Rock County is going back to its roots. Mark Dudlaw says they decided to change to a fully certified organic farm after his father was diagnosed with cancer in 2008. He believes the pesticides are harmful to both consumers and farmers.
I used to beat my hands on my chest, proud that I was feeding the world, but I really truly didn't understand at what cost.
Well, today's technology is far beyond the family's first generation, which dates back to 1805. Mark believes he's setting up not only his family, but everyone's next generation to be a healthier and happier Wisconsin. Time now for a check on your forecast. Here's Chief Meteorologist Cameron Moreland. Cam?
Hi, Nina. After back-to-back 80s, much cooler weather has moved into Wisconsin this afternoon. We now have mid to upper 60s across most of the state. And tomorrow's going to be even cooler. It looks like lower to mid 60s. We'll have a mixture of sun and clouds and gusty northeast winds. The normal high for this time of year is right around 70. For your latest news, sports, and weather, make sure you download the NBC 26 News app. It's available in the App Store and on Google Play. Just search for WGBA. Have a great day.